Joe Biden is almost halfway through his first term as presidency. Only now does he face his biggest political challenge to date, the midterms. As inflation jumps and prices climb, he faces pressure over cost of living. And while he battles to boost his popularity, Republicans are fighting to make his job a lot harder and improve their chances of securing the White House in 2024. But what are the midterms and why do they matter? Well, Congress is made up of the House and the Senate. The Senate has 100 representatives, 35 are up for election, while all 435 seats of the House are up for grabs. Right now in the Senate, of the 100 seats, Republicans have 50, Democrats 48, and there are two independents who back the Democrats. In the event of a tied vote in the Senate, the US Vice President, in this case Kamala Harris, has the deciding vote. So essentially, the Democrats control the Senate. Over in the House, the Democrats hold 220 of the 435 seats, giving them the balance of power. Republicans have 212. Democrats also have the White House. US President Joe Biden is in charge. Who has control of Congress determines whether the president's agenda can easily pass. If the Republicans pick up a net gain of one in the Senate during these midterms, then they would control it. If they were to have a net gain of five in the House, that would give them control of the House. And that's why these midterms are critically important for both US President Joe Biden, but also the Republicans. Because if the Republicans control the Senate or the House, they can thwart the president's plans, and a divided Congress adds more pressure to the president. If the Democrats can keep control of the House and the Senate, then Joe Biden's agenda becomes a lot easier to get through. History, though, is not on the side of the sitting president. Generally, midterms go against the White House. And because these elections are at the halfway point of a presidency, what happens on November 8 can also shape the lead up to the 2024 presidential election. Joe Biden faces mounting pressure over the economy, while abortion rights are also a key issue in many of the crucial states. But the Republicans also face questions over how they move forward and who could be their presidential candidate for 2024, with the likelihood Donald Trump will try and run again. Will Donald Trump's wing of the party remain dominant as they try to make the former president the future president? Or will an ambitious senator or governor emerge with the momentum to challenge for 2024?